हाय डियर फ्रेंड्स, सो द क्वेश्चन गिवन टू अस इज यू आर गिवन ए इंटीजर एरे कॉइंस. ओके, सो ए इंटीजर एरे कॉइंस इज गिवन टू अस. सो आई विल टेल यू अबाउट द कॉइंस. सो इट कंटेन द एलिमेंट 1, 2, and 5. ओके, ऑफ डिफरेंट डिनोमिनेशंस मीन्स ऑफ डिफरेंट रुपीज. एन इंटीजर इज गिवन अमाउंट. ओके, सो एन इंटीजर अमाउंट इज गिवन टू अस एंड दैट इज गिवन 5. ओके, सो वॉट इज द क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन इज वी नीड टू रिटर्न द नंबर ऑफ कॉम्बिनेशन दैट मेक अप द अमाउंट. ओके, सो वी हैव टू चूज सम कॉम्बिनेशंस फ्रॉम दीज कॉइन्स एंड वॉट वी हैव टू डू, वी हैव टू मेक दिस अमाउंट. इफ दैट अमाउंट ऑफ मनी कैन नॉट बी मेड बाई एनी कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ कॉइन, देन वी नीड टू रिटर्न इट 0. ओके, सो द क्वेश्चन इज वेरी सिंपल. क्वेश्चन सेज दैट अ कॉइन एरे विल बी गिवन एंड वी वॉन्ट द अमाउंट एज 5. इट मीन्स वॉट वी कैन डू, इफ वी आर गोइंग टू चूज द एलिमेंट्स लाइक दिस 1+1+1+1+1, देन हाउ मेनी कॉइन्स वी वॉट इज द सम वी आर गोइंग टू गेट 5. हियर देर इज वन कंडीशन दैट वी हैव अनलिमिटेड सप्लाई ऑफ दीज कॉइन्स. ओके, 1, 2, 5, यू कैन टेक एनी नंबर ऑफ कॉइन्स. सो दिस इज द वन पॉसिबल केस. वॉट कैन बी अदर पॉसिबल केस? यू टेक 1 1 rupee कॉइन एंड 2 2 rupees कॉइन, देन ऑल्सो सम इज गोइंग टू बी 5. Or you can do like this. You can take 3 1 rupee coin and 1 2 rupee coin. Then what you are going to get? Sum as 5. Okay. And what other you can take? You can take 1 5 rupee coin and the total amount will be 5. So these are only the 4 possible ways by which we can get this amount. So what output we need to return? We need to return the output as 4. Because there are 4 cases by which we can get this. Okay, this is the first one, this is second, this is third, and this is fourth. I hope question is very clear to you. Coin array is given, amount is given, we need to find the number of ways in which we can get the amount, and there is a condition that the supply of coins is unlimited for every denomination. Okay, so let's move to the solution part. So to solve this problem, there are many ways. First way is recursive way, and the second one is dynamic programming. So I will discuss both the ways. So first of all, let us move to the recursive way. In recursive way, we need 2 things. First thing is base condition and choice diagram. These are the 2 things that are required. Choice diagram. Perfect. So suppose let us define a function. What is the function name? Let us define the function name as count, and I am using the syntax of Python, right? So let us define a function count. Okay, so what are the things we are going to have? So we are going to get a coin array. Okay, coins array that I shown you earlier also. This is the coins array and the amount. These are the 2 things that we are going to get. We need to return the number of ways. So first of all, I told you we want 2 things, base condition and choice diagram. So now tell me one thing, how we approach the recursive solution. Here I will tell you. So a coin is given to us 1, 2, and 5. So in choice diagram, what we do, we start from the last element, then we move to the left hand side. So now the number of elements in this list are 3. Okay, in this array or list. So first of all, we need to take the decision on last element, then second last, then this one. Okay, so we need to take the decision on these elements, right? So first of all, n value will be 3. Sorry, this is 0, 1, 2. So here n value will be 2, here n value will be 1, and here n value will become 0. Okay, so n is changing, correct? This is the 0, 1, 2, what is this? This is the, we can say that, so 0, 1, 2 are the index of this array. So we need to approach by 0, 1, 2, okay? But the number of elements in the array are 3. So this, we need to take decision on that. And amount is also there. Okay, now tell me one thing. Let us take this amount. If you decided to choose the element 5, if you decided to choose the element 5, so what will be the amount? So if you decided to choose the element 5, now the required amount will be 0. Okay. So if you decided not to choose 5, okay, so amount will be 5 only. Now if you come to the position this, and if you decided to select 2, so what will be the required amount now? 3. Because you have already selected this 2. Now what you have to look for? You need to look for 3. So here the two things are being changed, amount and the number of elements. Okay, so before going to that, here what we are doing, here we are taking decision on every element 1, 2 and 5. First of all, we are taking the decision, either we have to select it or leave it. Okay, so whenever you get this feeling, either to select it or leave it, you will get to know that it is an abstract problem. Okay, one thing is clear. Whenever you have a choice for each element, either select it or leave it, it means this concept is related to the knapsack. One thing is clear. Now one more thing. If the supply of coins is unlimited, it means you can use one multiple time. You can also make the combination like this to get the required sum as 5. It means here the supply of coins is unlimited. You can choose each element more than once. It means this is not 01 knapsack, it is unbounded knapsack. Okay, it is unbounded knapsack. It is very important to analyze the problem, what kind of problem it is. Whenever we need to take the decision, either select it or leave it, it means it's the problem of knapsack. Now again, if the supply of coin is unlimited, it means it is unbounded knapsack. Okay, it is unbounded knapsack. So first of all, we need to write the base condition. So for base condition, we need to look at the things that are going to be changed. So here I am also going to take n. What is n? N is the length of the array or list. So n size will be changed. As I told you, we need to take the decision on the last element, then second last, like this. So n will be changing. So here we need to see what are the things that are changing. So we got that n is changing and amount is changing. So for base condition, I am going to write if n equal to 0. Okay, if there is no element in the coins list or array, are you going to get any kind of amount? Suppose a coin array is given with empty and they are saying that we want sum as 5. Is it possible? No. It means if n equal to 0, then what we need to return? We need to return 0. Correct? This is the first condition. Now, if this amount becomes 0, okay, I will tell you the case. If amount becomes 0, okay, suppose elements are given in the array 1, 2 and 5. Now tell me, if amount becomes 0, okay, they are saying that there are elements in the coin array, but we want final amount as 0. Is it possible? Yes, it is possible. How it is possible? Just take a null set, okay, we are going to take the subset from this, okay, so we are not going to select 1, 2, 5, then it will be an empty set and the sum of empty set is again 0. So it's possible. It means if sum equal to 0, then what we need to return? Then we need to return 1. Got it? So these are the two base conditions. Now choice diagram. What I told you regarding the choice diagram? Okay. So a coins array is given to us 1, 2, 5. So there are two things. Either select it or leave it. Suppose if you want amount as 4, instead of 5, I am taking the example of amount as 4. So are you going to select this 5? No. Why? Because this 5 is greater than 4. So in output, if you required final amount as 4, we are not going to select any number of coin which is greater than 5. So first of all, there is one condition that if the amount, that is coins of n minus 1, is greater than amount. Okay, I told you we will start from the end. So if this is greater, then what we need to do? We need to return. What we are going to do? We are going to leave this element. So what we need to do? We need to skip this element. So return, what is the function that we return? Count. Array will be same, but number of element will be decrease. So number of element will become n minus 1. Okay. Else, suppose you want amount 5. Okay. You want amount as 5 only. Right. So if you want amount as 5, then we have two choices. Either select it or leave it. Right. So then what we are going to do? We are going to return. First of all, I am going to choose the condition of leave it. Okay. So we are going to return count. Again, we are going to call the function coins. Now we have taken the decision on this element. So we are going to move on to. So elements are reduced. But if you are going to leave this amount, if you are not going to select it, so it will be same as it is, amount only. Okay. And what will be the second case? That we select it. So now also coins array will be sent. Number of elements will be decreased because we have taken the decision on 5, but the amount will be change. So amount minus this coin of n minus 1. Correct. So at the end, we want all the cases. So what we are going to do? We are going to add them. So what we need to do? Return coin n minus 1 plus n sum and coin n sum of amount of coin n minus 1. So this is the recursive approach. So in recursive approach, what we have done? It's a very simple code. In recursive approach, this is the base condition and this is the choice diagram. Okay, this we have done and this is our solution. Now if examiner asks to us, show some efficient way. So what we are going to do? We are going to use the dynamic programming approach, because recursive approach will take a lot of time as well as lot of space. So we are going to move to the dynamic programming approach. So dynamic programming approach. So in dynamic programming or DP, what is required? We need to create a matrix. Okay. So this time I am going to write the function name as change, because it's a coin change problem on read code. So define change that will take amount as well as coins. This is the list of array and this is the amount that is required. So first of all, what we need to do? We need to create a DP. So it will be like this. We are going to start all the elements with the 0. Correct. So for 0 for every element in range of columns and then rows. So first of all, what will be the column? Amount plus 1. And what will be the rows? For every element in range of length of coins plus 1. Right? Or you can write like this. N is equal to length of coins. So here, instead of length of coin, you can write N plus 1. Okay. So basically, what is the approach of DP? I will tell you. Okay. Let's come this side, so it will not disturb our exact solution. So in DP, what we do? We create a table, right? So here contain the number of elements. So coins array given to us contain the element 1, 2, and 5. So here what we need to do? We need to make a array DP of n plus 1, that is 3 plus 1 and 5 plus 1. So 0 1 2 3. Okay, till here we need to create this. Okay. Now here what we want? We want 6, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Sorry, till 5 only we need, because 5 plus 1 it is. Correct. So here there are number of elements and here is the required amount. So what this shows? Okay. This 0, 1, दिस जीरो सेज द नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इन द कॉइन एरे. सो जीरो मीन्स देर इज नो एलिमेंट इन द कॉइन्स एरे. नो एलिमेंट इन द कॉइन्स एरे. नाउ वन सेज दैट वी वॉन्ट फाइनल अमाउंट एज वन. इज इट पॉसिबल? नो, इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल. इफ यू हैव नो एलिमेंट इन द कॉइन्स एरे देन हाउ कैन यू गेट अमाउंट एज वन? कैन यू गेट अमाउंट एज वन? नो. इंस्टेड ऑफ वन इफ अमाउंट इज टू कैन यू गेट? If there are no elements in the array, we cannot get any amount. It means all the elements here will be zero. Okay. So in DP, what we need to do? We need to fill first row and first column manually. Then it will give us the final result. So suppose now array contain one element. Array contain one element, and what is the first element? One. Okay. But this time, what we want? We want amount as zero. Here it is zero na. So this time we want amount as zero. So if we have only one coin, can we get amount as zero? Yes, we can get. We are not going to select that one. At that point of time, we are going to get amount as zero. Perfect. It means there is one possible case. So if two elements are given in the array, one and two, now tell me, can you get amount as zero? Yes, you can get. If you are going to choose no element, then you are going to get amount as zero. It means null set. It means first row and first column we have to fill this manually. So we have created this DP starting with each element is zero. But what we want? We want this first row should be filled with the first one. Okay. Now what is DP? DP is nothing but breaking your complex problem into small problem. So here what this 3 tells? This 3 tells that we have 3 elements in our array, that is 1, 2 and 5. But we want sum as 0. What this tell? We want amount as 1. What this will tell? This will tell that we want final amount as 5, and this was the question. It means DP is nothing but breaking your complex problem into small sub problems, and at the end we will get our solution by that complex small problems. It means the last element of this matrix will give us our final result. So we got it. So first of all, what we have done? We have started each element with the zero. Now what I told you, first row should be started with one. It means for I in range, and what is this we need to write the columns. So columns is n plus 1, correct? So what we need to do? We need to fill the DP I comma 0 with 1, correct? So we have first we have created the DP, then we have filled the first row with the 1. Now what we need to do? Now we need to do the same thing that we have done earlier in the recursive solution. Okay, so what we are going to do? We are going to replace n with I and amount with j. Perfect. So in recursive solution, what we were doing? So first of all, we were traversing to all the elements. So at that time, we were using recursive approach. But now what we are going to use? We are going to use the for loop. So for I in range, and we have filled the first row and first column, so I am starting with 1. So it will be from 1 to n plus 1. This is the row. Now what we need to do? Column for j in range from 1 to amount plus 1. Plus 1. Perfect. So this we are doing. So what we were doing there? So I was saying that if elements have 1, 2 and 5, and suppose if you want final amount as 4, so if this element is greater than, if 5 is greater than 4, then we are going to leave that element. So first of all, I am going to write this condition. If that coins array, that is I minus 1, is greater than j, I told you n will be replaced with I and amount will be replaced with j. If it is greater, then we are going to leave that element. So DP of I comma j, DP of I comma j, it will be DP of I minus 1 comma j. ओके व्हाट वी वर डूइंग, वी वर शिफ्टिंग टू वन एलिमेंट बैक. व्हाट वी वर डूइंग, वी वर डूइंग एन माइनस वन. सो हियर व्हाट वी आर डूइंग, आई माइनस वन. परफेक्ट. एल्स वी हैव टू चॉइसेस, आइदर सेलेक्ट इट और लीव इट. सो डीपी ऑफ आई कॉमा जे विल बी, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, वी आर गोइंग टू राइट द कोड फॉर लीव इट. सो इट विल बी आई माइनस वन कॉमा जे. नाउ वी हैव चूजन द कंडीशन दैट ओके लीव दिस एलिमेंट फाइव, लीव दिस फाइव, राइट, लीव दिस फाइव. नाउ वी नीड टू टेक द डिसीजन ऑन टू. सो हियर ऑल्सो वी हैव टू चॉइस, आइदर सेलेक्ट इट और लीव इट. एंड इफ यू डिसाइडेड टू टेक द टू, then you can again come back to this 2 and you can select it. Okay, you can make the set like this 1 2 2. So what will be the sum? Sum will be 5. It means if you are going to select 2, so you can again come back to this number. It means you can again come, so it will be dp of I and it will be j minus coins of I minus 1. What this means, why we have not write I minus 1? Because if you have taken the decision on this element, if you have taken the decision on this element, you can come back and again take the decision. So this time we have not written I minus 1. So dp of I, j of coins, I minus 1. So at the end, where we are going to get the solution? We are going to get solution at the last. So you can write like this, dp of n comma amount. Okay. Or Python you can write like this, dp of minus 1 comma minus 1. It will give you the last value. Okay, I hope you got the question. The question was very simple. An array was given to us. Then we need to decide what we have to do. Okay, one small mistake I have done. Suppose if you are going to select this element, if you are going to select this element, then you can come back again to 5 and you can take the decision. It means whenever you are going to select the element, okay, whenever you are going to select the element, n value will not be changed, okay, because I told you, if you have decided that we should not take 5, then, okay, no issue, you come one step backward. But if you have decided to take this 1, then you can come back again to the 1 and you can take the decision. It means n value will be same if you are selecting the element. So here also in recursive solution also n will come, and if in dynamic programming also it will be only I. But if you are going to exclude that element, if you are going to exclude that element, at that time you don't have to come back again to that element, so it will be I minus 1. I hope I cleared your question. Still, if you have any doubt, you can tell me in the comment section. Still, if you feel that I have done any mistake, that also you can mention in the comment section so that I can improve in my next video. Thanks a lot for watching the video.